Mr. Goel, I think your ministry has some interesting experiences very recently. Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Odisha, three non-BJP ruled states have all signed up for the debt recast and revival program for DISCOMs. How can we build on this cooperation some more?
Well, just to put the perspective, two Congress states also, Uttarakhand and Himachal, have also signed up. And that in a way covers nearly 90% of the debt of the DISCOMs, more than 3/4 of the country. And the advantage was that this was an entirely bottom-up approach. The central government has decided nothing under Uday. It's all been decided by the bankers, by the state governments, the DISCOMs, consumer organizations. And it's been an iterative process that we ran through several times. Possibly I would have sat into at least 100 plus meetings while this was evolving, right up to 2 days before the cabinet when we made some changes for Jharkhand and Jammu Kashmir. We also kept it voluntary. We have not tried to impose it on any state. So really my job ended the day Uday was approved by the cabinet, because now the officials are talking amongst themselves and sorting out the nitty-gritties. And to my mind, there is a time up to which we can wait for other political parties to respond to this clarion call of the people of India that they want a better quality of life. Beyond that, we may have to possibly look at alternate mechanisms. We may have to look at alternate paths to achieve the same goal. And I have no doubt that Rahul Bhai is absolutely right. It was a brilliant question to begin with. That beyond a stage, if we are not able to get them on board, I'm sure the Honorable Finance Minister must be having a trick or two up his sleeve which he can't disclose in a award function. But we'll have to move beyond trying to just look at one act or one law as being the panacea of all the problems of this country. I remember when even the coal mines bills were under consideration of Parliament. In the first session, in the winter session of 2014, I was not able to get it passed. There was disruption in the House. Though the Lok Sabha, which represents the will of the people, was on board in the upper house, we were not able to get through. In the budget session, I think the realization dawned on almost all the parties, as Finance Minister rightly said, that the benefit, not one rupee of that benefit, of a transparent and honest auction was being kept by the centre. And in fact, it was the Honourable Finance Minister himself who, when we were discussing in a small group about the law, he said, no, this money should go to the states. Centre will not keep a single rupee out of it. It was his sagacity that brought me to a situation that there was a pan-India consensus on approving that. Of course, as he rightly said, politics, end of the day, does prevail. And only three political parties opposed it. One was, of course, the yours truly that you are all discussing. Possibly they didn't want honesty and transparency to come into the system. They preferred the earlier mechanism where they could favor their friends and family and a few corporates. The other was the left parties, which obviously don't want any good to happen to the country. He just spoke about Kerala and West Bengal and the pitiable state they are in. The third was the DMK, and again a party we all know has been ousted out and almost has been decimated in Parliament thanks to the way they conducted themselves while they were in government. Other than these three, every political party, north to south, east to west, of every ideology, supported that. And I think the pressure built up on the rest not to disrupt the Parliament and not to oppose it, just like the public pressure helped us pass the Juvenile Amendment Act right now. So to my mind, we need the people of India to also come on board and take this as a shared responsibility. It cannot just be left to a set of people in one family to hold the country to ransom. But it also cannot be just said that it's the responsibility of the Honorable Prime Minister and Finance Minister to resolve the problems of the country. I think when all of us work together, as Paul Coelho said, once all of us desire good to happen, the entire universe will conspire to make it happen.
That's true.